Hi everyone, welcome to today's session. Today we are going to learn the last topic of your chapter force, uniform circular motion and centripetal force. Come on, let's check it out. What is uniform circular motion and centripetal force? What is uniform circular motion? Why it is called uniform circular motion? What is uniform in a circular motion? Let's check it out. What is uniform circular motion? When a particle moves with a constant speed in a circular path, this motion is said to be uniform circular motion. You have studied in lower classes. So in such motion, look at this figure drawn on the board. In such motion, the particle travels equal distance in equal interval of time. It is possible. It may cover equal distance in equal interval of time. When a particle covers equal distance in equal interval of time, we say that its speed is constant or speed is uniform. So in a uniform circular motion, what is constant? What is uniform? Speed is constant. Alright? So speed remains constant in a uniform circular motion. But look at the direction of particle at each point on the circle. So at any point, the direction of motion is along the tangent drawn at that point. You can see in the diagram. This is the direction of motion. So at every point on the circle, or each point on the circle, the direction of the particle continuously changes. Alright? So, let us check it out how it happens. Let us consider one more example. An athlete is running around a rectangular track. He has to change the direction of motion at each corner. Okay? Four times. How many times? One, two, three, four times to stay on the track. Alright? Now, if the number of side I am increasing, progressively increases, and it forms a hexagon, hexagonal track, how many times he has to change the direction? One, two, three, four, five, six times. And gradually it increases to a polygon, ultimately, and it comes to a circle. So, this means that if the athlete wants to remain on the circular track, he must change his direction of motion at every point. Okay? So at every point, he must change the direction of motion. Alright? If he moves along a circular path with a uniform speed, he can move along the circular path with a uniform speed, but his velocity is not constant. Right? You understood from this example? So there is a change in direction brings about change in the velocity. You know, velocity changes either when its magnitude changes or the direction changes. The magnitude of the velocity is not changing here. The velocity, magnitude of velocity, say for example 2 meter per second, it can be constant. The magnitude is not changing. But look at the direction. So the direction of the velocity, starting at A, it is towards north. Now it is towards, see, towards west, south, east. So the direction is changing. So the velocity changes because of the change in direction. This change in velocity gives rise to an acceleration of the motion. You know that whenever there is a change in velocity, there is an acceleration produced. Acceleration is nothing but, we can write, acceleration is nothing but it is rate of change of velocity, dv by dt. Whenever there is change in velocity, there is acceleration. If the velocity is constant, acceleration is zero. The magnitude of the velocity is not changing, but its direction changes, so the acceleration is produced. So such a type of acceleration produced in a uniform circular motion, we call it as centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration A is equal to V square upon R. What is the magnitude? V square upon R, where V is the velocity, R is the radius of the circular path. This is the radius of the circular path. Alright? So, centripetal acceleration. You may ask, acceleration being a vector quantity, what is the direction of centripetal acceleration? So, centripetal acceleration is always acting towards the center. Like this, towards the center. And also, you know that the acceleration and velocity is always acting normal to each other, perpendicular to each other. See, velocity and acceleration are perpendicular to each other, and the acceleration is directed towards the center. At this point also directed towards center, everywhere it is directed towards the center. All right, so the direction of the acceleration is towards the center. All right, and you may ask whether this acceleration is changing or not. Of course, the acceleration is also variable here. How it is possible? See, the magnitude of the acceleration, for example, acceleration is equal to say 1 meter per second square. Okay, the magnitude 1 meter per second square, it remains constant at every point. But what about the direction? See, the direction of the acceleration, see, towards the center here, towards the left, it is directed downward, towards right, towards up. Okay, so at each point of the circle, the direction of the acceleration changes, but the magnitude remains constant. So we can say that the acceleration is also variable here. Acceleration is variable here. Velocity is also variable here. In uniform circular motion, velocity is also variable. We have seen earlier. All right. And this type of acceleration, we call it as centripetal acceleration. Okay. And whose magnitude is given by A is equal to V square upon R. It is directed towards the center. All right. So what is the difference between a uniform circular motion and a uniform linear motion? Circular motion moving in a circular path, in a linear motion, the body moves in a straight line path. So in uniform linear motion, the speed and velocities are constant. So in uniform linear motion, speed and velocity can be constant, but acceleration can be zero. All right. So uniform linear motion is an unaccelerated motion because acceleration is zero. Speed and velocity remains constant. While in case of a circular motion, velocity is variable. All right. So it is an accelerated motion. So uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion because of the change in velocity. So that is the difference between uniform circular motion and uniform linear motion. Uniform linear motion is unaccelerated motion, but uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion. All right. Yeah. So since it is an accelerated motion, uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion, a force is required to produce an accelerated motion, or to bring about change in velocity, or to produce an acceleration, a force is required. And what is the name of that force acting in a uniform circular motion? From where it is coming? What is the direction of this force acting in a uniform circular motion? So we can say that a force acting in a uniform circular motion, we call it as centripetal force. I call it as centripetal force. Centripetal force. Okay, so if you consider a uniform circular motion, centripetal force is acting at every point, right? Acting at every point A, B, C, D. The particle moves in an anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction. At every point, force is required to produce an acceleration or to make the body move in the circular path. So this centripetal force is always directed towards the center along the circular path, along the direction of acceleration. Okay, acceleration will be there along the direction of the force applied. You know it. So the force is acting along the radius of the circular path, towards the center, towards the center. So what is the direction of this centripetal force? The centripetal force is directed towards the center along the radius. All right. So what is the magnitude of this centripetal force? So I can write F is equal to ma, where a is the centripetal acceleration. We have found out an expression for centripetal acceleration somewhere. Yeah, a is equal to v square upon r. So I can write F is equal to m v square upon r. So remember this expression, centripetal acceleration, centripetal force is equal to mv square upon r, where m is the mass of the particle, v is the velocity of the particle, r is the radius of the circular path, All right. So a centripetal force is the force acting on a body moving in a circular path in a direction towards the center of the circular path. All right. Okay. So in a uniform circular motion, centripetal force is responsible for making the body move in a circular path. If there is no centripetal force, body will not move in a circular path. All right, whose magnitude is given by F is equal to mv square upon r. See, the centripetal force is also a variable quantity here. The magnitude remains same. For example, here, say for 10 newton. Okay, the magnitude of the centripetal force will be constant at each and every point here. But what about the direction? See, the direction at the point D, it is, see, towards the center, towards left, towards downward, towards right, towards up. So at each and every point A, B, C, D, the direction of the force is changing, but the magnitude remains same. So we can say that centripetal force is also variable here. Okay, acceleration is variable. Acceleration is variable. Velocity is variable. But what remains constant? Speed. Speed remains constant in a uniform circular motion. Okay, now let us see some examples of uniform circular motion. Some examples of uniform circular motion. Okay, a very familiar example we will consider. In an atom, you know that electrons are moving around the nucleus in a circular path. Examples. Let us consider very easy examples of circular motion. Motion of electron. This is nucleus, positively charged nucleus. Electrons are moving around the nucleus in a circular path. Alright? So, force is required for the motion of the electron in a circular path. Since it is an accelerated motion, which force is responsible for this? From where this centripetal force comes? The centripetal force is provided by the electrostatic force of attraction between the electron and the positively charged nucleus. So, you know that there is a strong electrostatic force of attraction between negatively charged electron and positively charged nucleus. And this electrostatic force of attraction provides the necessary centripetal force, which is directed towards the center, which makes electron move around the circular path. Consider the motion of the planet around the sun. Very simple. Motion of the planet around the sun. Planet moving around the sun in a circular path. An example of uniform circular motion. The sun attracts the planet with a strong force of gravity, and this gravitational pull of the sun on the planet provides the necessary centripetal force. It is directed towards the sun. The sun is pulling the planet with a certain force of gravity, and this force of gravity provides the necessary centripetal force for the planet to move around in a circular path. Now, another very simple common example is, take the case when a stone is tied at one end of a string and is whirled in a circular path, holding other end in one hand. So, a piece of stone. So, it moves in a, it is whirled. Now, you are just whirling around it. Okay. So, it moves in a circular path. Right? Okay. So, there is a force acting. You know that, of course, the centripetal force. From where the centripetal force comes? The centripetal force is provided by the force of tension acting along the string. So, there is a tension developed on the string, which is always directed towards the center. And this tension is nothing but, it is the centripetal force. And tension provides the centripetal force necessary for the stone to move around in a circular path. So, in all these examples, very common example that you have picked up from our daily life, a force is required for circular motion, and force, we call it as centripetal force, which is directed towards the center. Alright? Yeah. The centripetal force is the action force, of course. So you may ask, sir, where is the reaction force? Since there is an action force, of course there can be a reaction force. And this reaction force, I call it as centrifugal force. I call it as centrifugal force. Centrifugal force. Okay. And this centrifugal force is assumed to be acting on the body in a direction away from the circular path. If action force and reaction force both are in the opposite direction, if centripetal force is acting directed towards the center of the circular path, where will be the centrifugal force will be acting? It will be acting, since it will be acting away from the centripetal force. Okay, this is, we call it as centripetal force, centrifugal force, which is always acting away from the circular path. Centripetal force is the force of tension. It is acting towards the center of the circular path. All right. Since both these forces act on two different body, it is not the real force. Remember that the centrifugal force is not a real force. It's also called a fictitious force or pseudo force or virtual force. So remember that centrifugal force is not a real force, since both the bodies, both the forces do not act on the same body. It is not the real force. So why do we consider, in order to describe the circular motion, we consider centrifugal force. Okay, so it's a fictitious force, it's a virtual force. Just we consider it to explain the circular, uniform circular motion. All right, I hope the points are clear to you. Fine.